How to back up Windows. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. So if you've been following me for any length of time, a week will probably do it, you'll know that I am a huge fan of backing up. Backing up is the closest thing to a silver bullet to protect you from just about anything that could go wrong. And as we know, things can and do go wrong. This video will essentially be an overview of the steps I recommend you take to protect yourself with a backup of Windows. Now, I'm not going to be going into the details of each step. However, in the description, you'll find a link to the article that this video is based on. That article has further links to detailed instructions for each of the steps. Those links also include videos if that's your preferred style, but the bottom line here is check out the link in the description. It's askleo.com/30103. So, step one is an image backup. Make an image backup. An image backup is quite literally a full image of absolutely everything that's on your hard drive. It's fundamental to a backup strategy, in my opinion. The reason it is so critical is that there's no question about what is and is not within that backup. It backs up everything. The great use case that I think demonstrates why it's so useful is that if your hard disk fails, well, you replace the hard disk, you restore the most recent image, and you're back where you started. There's no additional work. It just works because you've backed up absolutely everything. That's step one. Step two, then, is to make a recovery disk. When you use backup software, in order for that backup software to be able to restore to that replacement hard disk, you need to be able to boot into something. That replacement hard disk, for example, is empty. So the restore disk, sometimes called a recovery disk or an emergency disk, is actually a USB stick in most cases these days that is created by your backup software for use in an emergency. What you do then is you boot from it. And typically when you boot from these emergency disks, it will automatically fire up a copy of the backup software you're using, ready to restore a backup image. The good news here, by the way, is that an emergency disk can also often be used to backup a machine that perhaps you can't boot into. Number three, restoring an image. It's what everybody asks about. When I've got a backup image, great, what do I do with it? Well, restoring an image is literally the process of taking that image that you've created and restoring it to your hard disk. Now, I don't suggest you do this unless or until you need to. I have some ideas on how to go about basically ensuring that a restore will work, but understanding what the process is and how it works will help you understand why that backup image is so important and how it will be used in case of that kind of a disaster. On the other hand, step number four is to restore individual files from that image. You don't have to restore the entire image. In fact, it's very useful to basically recover an individual file or an individual folder or whatever you want, often something you didn't realize was important. And because it's an image backup, you have absolutely everything. So being able to extract individual files from that image is an incredibly useful piece of functionality. Number five, we're going to move on from image backups. And I'm going to suggest you go ahead and set up Windows file history. File history uses space, typically on an external hard disk, to back up files you're working on roughly as they change. It's one of those things that is very easy to turn on, very low cost, and the external drive you could use could easily be the same external drive you're using for your image backups. Number six, well, being able to restore a file from file history. I want you to understand how that works, what that looks like, so that you know what it is you're getting when you enable file history. Number seven, use OneDrive. Now, I say OneDrive because you have it. If you're running Windows, you already have OneDrive on your machine. However, this same philosophy works well with Dropbox, Google One, Google Drive, other alternatives. But I focus mostly on OneDrive, like I said, because you have it. The issue is that a good backup strategy includes making sure that there are backups of your important files somewhere else, literally physically somewhere else. Your external hard disk is probably right next to your computer or not far away. If your entire house or building or whatever were to be destroyed or caught up in fire, then what's called an off-site backup is the way to basically protect yourself. And by definition, OneDrive is an off-site backup. And set up properly, it works transparently in the background, saving what you're working on often more quickly even than file history. And then finally, step eight is OneDrive itself has its own recycle bin. And it also has protection specifically for ransomware. These are wonderful features that, again, provide another safety net for files that are either accidentally deleted or corrupted or whatnot. They could often be recovered by heading out to OneDrive.com and restoring the file from the backups, the recycle bin, and the ransomware protection that are already enabled for you. Now, one thing I haven't talked about that I used to talk about when I talked about this specific process is the built-in backup in Windows. It's referred to as the Windows 7 backup, and it allows you to create images. Microsoft specifically has told us that we should no longer be using that. It is deprecated. What that means is that they're not making any changes to it, they're not fixing any bugs, and they may eventually remove it from Windows completely. They specifically suggest you use third-party tools. So while there is an image backup built into Windows, don't use it. We'll use third-party tools. I typically recommend tools like Macrium Reflect or Isis to do, but there are other good tools that will do the same, that will protect you by creating the backups, the image backups that we're talking about. So that's the overview. Again, the link for the article that goes into this in much more detail, including step-by-step instructions for each of the steps I've talked about, is down in the description. For updates, for comments, for all those links related to this topic and more, again, visit askleo.com/30103. Thanks for watching.